Hi, my name is Saj Rai, and on behalf of Simply Learn, I'd like to welcome you to this exciting world of cybersecurity and the path to becoming a certified ethical hacker. Let's begin by understanding what's in it for you. We'll first begin by understanding who is a certified ethical hacker. Next, we'll understand how to become a certified ethical hacker. We'll discuss the CEH exam content outline. And finally, we'll understand how the certification can help you skyrocket your salary and your career. So who is a certified ethical hacker? An ethical hacker, also referred to as a white hat hacker, is an information security expert who systematically attempts to penetrate a computer system, network, application, or other computer resources on behalf of its owners, and of course with their permission, to find security weaknesses and vulnerabilities that a malicious hacker could potentially exploit. You need to pass CEH exam in order to become a certified ethical hacker. Originally, the term hacker referred to someone with an advanced understanding of computers and computer networks who could probably do anything with a computer system. Unfortunately, over a period of time, media has portrayed hacker as the bad guy, and thus there is a negative connotation associated with the term hacker. The hackers argue that cracker is the more appropriate term for the bad guys, those who break into computers for criminal purposes. Nevertheless, the more appropriate term to use today is a black hat for those who hack with criminal intent and white hat or ethical hackers for those who hack to identify security issues in the systems. The more important term to understand here is ethical. Ethical hackers plays the important role of predicting various probable vulnerabilities and security lapses in an organization before a malicious black hat hacker can exploit them. But they do so in a manner which is ethical and in the best interest of the organization. The ethical hackers uses the same steps to hack as a black hat would do. The ethical hackers also uses the same tools to hack. And the ethical hackers needs to think like a malicious attacker. To beat a hacker, you need to think like a hacker. Although the word hacker tends to evoke negative connotations when referred to, it is important to remember that all hackers are not created equal. As I mentioned previously, black hats are the individuals with extraordinary computing skills but performing activities that are malicious or destructive in nature. They are sometimes referred to as crackers. White hats, also known as ethical hackers, are individuals with relevant hacking skills who utilize their knowledge for defensive purposes, for example, to protect organizations from hacking attacks. They are also known as security analysts. Gray hat, on the other hand, are individuals who work offensively as well as defensively at various times. The important question is how to become a certified ethical hacker. In order to become a certified ethical hacker, you need to pass the Certified Ethical Hacker or the CEH exam from EC Council, which tests the broad knowledge of subject matter that is required for someone to be an effective ethical hacker. Well, since its inception in 2003, the Certified Ethical Hacker has been the absolute choice of the industry globally. It is recognized worldwide and has been endorsed by governmental agencies like the NSA. The CEH exam is also accredited by ANSI, which adds credibility and value to the credential members. The CEH exam is computerized, proctored exam. You'll have 4 hours to complete 125 questions. There are some sources of information that mentions that in order to pass, you need to score about 60 to 80%. The actual percentage of questions that you must answer correctly varies from exam to exam and depends on the difficulty of the exams delivered when you take the exam. The harder the questions that are asked, the fewer questions you need to get right to pass the exam. If you get easier questions, then you will need to get more of the questions right to pass the exam. However, keep in mind that when you take the actual exam at the testing center, the passing grade may vary. The CEH certification exam costs $500 plus an additional eligibility fee of $100. The exam duration is for 4 hours. The questions are all multiple choice. The exam is only available in English as of today. Candidates can take the CEH exam online using a remotely proctored service from anywhere in the world 24/7 as long as they have a computer equipped with a webcam and a microphone. Let's discuss the exam outline. The exam is broken into 7 domains. Networking and information background covers about 32%. Analysis assessment covers 12%. Security covers 23%. Tools system programs 29%. Procedures methodology 9%. Regulation policy 2%. And ethics 3%. Let's discuss these domains a little more in detail. Networking and information background. This first domain of the CEH exam is designed to test your knowledge of everything that you need to know to practice ethical hacking, which isn't specific to any information security domain. The objectives of this domain include network and communication technologies. Next is information security threats and attack vector, such as malwares, OWASP top 10, etc. The final objective covers information security technologies such as mobile technologies, telecommunication technologies, backups, archiving, etc. Analysis assessment. This domain of the Certified Ethical Hacker exam is designed to test your knowledge of what goes into performing a penetration test or ethical hacking. The objectives of this domain are information security assessment and analysis and information security assessment process. Combination of ethics and regulation policy domains covers 5% of the total exam weightage. The objectives of these domains are ethics of information security, which covers what is considered ethical and unethical from the perspective of the CEH certification. Not only you will be expected to behave ethically, you will be expected to adhere to a code of ethics. Next objective is information security policies, laws, acts, which covers some of the major information security regulations and the evaluation of organizational security policies. This is an important procedures methodology. This is an important domain and carries a weightage of 9%. There are two objectives. The first objective covers information security procedures, which is the step-by-step methods that is used to identify, prevent, and enforce security controls against unwanted behavior. The next objective is information security assessment methodologies, which covers security assessments to determine security gaps that may pose a risk to the organization. Tools, systems, programs. This domain carries the maximum weightage of 29%, and so you should expect the maximum number of questions from here. This domain is heavily focused on knowledge of the specific systems, programs, and tools used in ethical hacking. There are three objectives. First objective covers information security systems such as firewalls, intrusion detection and prevention systems, SIEM solutions, etc. Next objective covers information security programs that are used to secure a host system against malicious attackers. These programs include antivirus, anti-spyware, anti-riskware, ad blockers, anti-rootkit, etc. The final objective covers information security tools used for performing footprinting and reconnaissance, performing enumeration, conducting network scanning, performing web application hacking, etc. The security domain is the second largest domain on the exam with 23% weightage. This domain is divided into three objectives. The first objective covers information security controls such as administrative controls, technical controls, and physical controls. The second objective, information security attack detection, covers various methods to detect attacks against an organization's information security. The final objective, information security attack prevention, covers proactive methods that organizations can use to protect themselves from malicious attacks. So the biggest question is how CEH will help you skyrocket your salary and your career. With the increasing number of successful hacking incidents, ethical hackers are in high demand in almost every industry. Given the nature of the job and the skills required, ethical hackers are highly paid. CEH certified professionals typically earn about 44% higher salaries than their non-certified peers. According to payscale.com, the average payout to a certified ethical hacker is $71,331 per annum in the United States and 5.5 lakh rupees in India. While these numbers varies depending on the experience, location, and nature of work, CEH is considered amongst the top highest paying certifications. Finally, let me quickly tell you about SimplyLearn's CEH certification training program. SimplyLearn offers instructor-led online training class for certified ethical hacking, where you will master the tools and techniques used by hackers and information security professionals so that you will be able to defend your organization against future attacks. SimplyLearn is an accredited training partner of EC Council, and all the trainers are certified by EC Council. The unique advantage with SimplyLearn is that you can attend multiple batches with multiple trainers at your own convenience. As part of the course, you will get 6 months free access to iLabs and also receive study material by EC Council. I hope this was helpful, and I'd like to thank you for watching. For more information, visit simplylearn.com.
Hi there. If you like this video, subscribe to the Simply Learn YouTube channel and click here to watch similar videos. To nerd up and get certified, click here.